calories in, calories out. It's a very seductively simple notion and a very easy and convenient way for us to think we understand the dynamics of weight gain and weight loss. And it's a very convenient idea for the food companies who produce all the food we eat, because they can stand back and say they have no responsibility for our health crisis and our body weight crisis. Now, there are lots of videos out there that try to explain this, and I have not yet seen one that explains it in simple, easy to understand English. So this is my attempt to do that. Welcome to ShapeFixer. I'm Andrew. I'm a nutritionist. I'm also a science and biology teacher. And I've had my issues with weight, and I don't have them now because now I eat properly. So let's talk about this calories in, calories out myth, because that's what it is. Firstly, what is a calorie? A calorie, strictly speaking, as a scientist, is a measure of heat. It's a measure of heat energy. I don't eat heat. I eat food. Food has a mass, and food is made of chemicals that can be converted to other chemicals in your body, to build your body, to repair your body, to make hormones. Yes, some of it gets burnt because you need energy as well. And some of it even turns to heat. That's why you get hot when you eat a meal. You take your jersey off halfway through dinner because your body heat, your body temperature goes up and you give off heat. If you warm your food up in a microwave before you eat it, you're making it hotter. It has more calories in it when you eat it because it's hotter and calories are a measure of heat. So the very idea that your food consists of a set number of calories is complete and utter nonsense, actually. So what do they mean when they say this packet of food contains 150 calories? What do they actually mean? What they mean is, if you took that food and you burnt it completely, incinerated it in an oven, and turned it into carbon dioxide gas and water vapor with a little bit of ash left at the bottom that could not be burnt any further, the total amount of heat given off in that incineration process could theoretically be measured in calories. And that's the number they're trying to show when they put it on the packet. But how relevant is that? Firstly, it's very difficult to determine what the total heat energy would be of that food if you were to incinerate it like that. And for that reason, the law allows for a bit of error on the packet, and the food companies are allowed to get the number within 20%. And that could be 20% high or 20% low. So they've got a 40% range that they can operate in when they tell you how many calories are in that food. So for starters, the number is garbage anyway. But even the idea is garbage. Because when you eat that food that could potentially burn and incinerate and turn to ash and give off carbon dioxide, all the amount of heat that's given off, how is that relevant? And how are you going to measure that? You can't measure it. When you take your jersey off at dinner because you're getting hot because you're eating, you can't measure how many calories of heat are churning out of your body into the room. It depends how hot the room is. It depends on all sorts of things. So even if the number that you're using for calories in, which we know is very inaccurate and pretty meaningless, how are you going to measure calories out? You can't. So it's ridiculous. The point of weight gain and weight loss is obviously associated with how much you eat, because if you overeat, you're going to put on weight, and if you starve yourself, you're going to lose weight, neither of which is a healthy strategy. So let's be clear on that one. But far more important than how much you eat is what you eat. Sugar has a higher percentage of the mass of the food that you eat, let's say a big bowl of pasta, which is mostly glucose, which is sugar, a lot of that is going to turn to body fat if you don't burn it for energy, because that's the only thing sugar is good for. It can't be used to build tissues, to build hormones, to build enzymes, to repair damage, to boost your immune system. It can't. Carbohydrates cannot be used for that. They can only be burnt because they're made of sugar. So you have to burn them. If you don't burn them, you will put on weight. What you eat is way more important than how much you eat. You're weighing your food, trying to count the calories, whatever that even means, is a waste of time. If you eat correctly, okay, you eat a proper ketogenic, low sugar, low carbohydrate diet. Now that can be paleo diet, an Atkins diet, a carnivore diet over here, a vegan diet over there, so long as it's low sugar, it doesn't matter. If you eat properly and you eat healthy, real food, and you try to avoid highly processed foods, and you cut down on your sugar intake, and please understand that sugar means all sugar, starch, carbohydrates are sugar, that's what they're made of, and you cut down on the sugar, your metabolism will work correctly. And when your metabolism works correctly, your hormones work correctly. And you have hormones that tell you when to eat. And you have hormones that tell you when to stop eating. And they work. They work brilliantly. Your body is a lot cleverer than you are. It really is. And it knows. And you don't feel like eating when you don't need to eat. But when you eat a lot of carbohydrates, and you start messing with your insulin levels, because your insulin rises when you eat carbohydrates and your blood sugar goes up, it plays havoc with the operation of your hunger and satiety hormones. And your body no longer knows when to stop. And you love it. And the sensation of eating the sugary sweet, or not even always sweet, some carbohydrates are not sweet at all. That's the trick. You just eat until your stomach is so stretched that you feel terrible, and that's when you stop. Well, by then you've eaten way too much, and it's got nothing to do with calories. You've just eaten too much food, and you're going to put on weight. And mostly you're putting on weight because you're eating sugar, and you can't burn fat when you eat sugar, and we've done videos about that. So I'm going to link a couple of videos at the end of this video about what you really should be eating and why. Please get in the comments below if you have any other observations to make on this issue. And if you don't agree with me, that's fine. We can have conversations about it, because that's the point of science and research into nutrition, into any aspect of science. But let me just say, please, if you're going to disagree with me and be insulting, or just give me dismissive one-liners, I'm actually just going to delete the comment and block you from the channel, because I don't have energy for this. What I have too many serious people following this channel who want to understand how this works. And so we can have a scientific conversation about it, and that's absolutely fine. But really, for those of you who really want to understand this, calories in, calories out is nonsense, because it's not something you can measure. It is an idea that was created by the food industry to make sure that you think it's your fault and your fault alone if you're unhealthy or you're overweight. Because you're either a greedy fat pig, or you're just a lazy slob. It's your fault. This is crap. This is crap. We are being told to eat food that is making us unhealthy. It's making us overweight. It's resulting in us ending up on chronic lifetime medication. And that's not the reason they're making the food. The reason they're making this food is just to make money. It's convenient. It's cheap. It can be mass produced. And it's very profitable. So the food industry has an interest in keeping us on this addictive, unhealthy food. The pharmaceutical industry has an interest in keeping us on lifetime medication. Nobody makes money out of us being perfectly healthy and eating proper food and not running off to the hospital. So, unfortunately, you're up against it. But if you understand that calories in, calories out is nonsense, it's an oversimplification, it's a very seductive idea because it's easy to follow. I'm going to say understand, but nobody understands it because it's nonsense. And there we go. There's my explanation for it. Calories are a measure of heat. We don't eat heat. And we don't only produce heat. Okay? We build tissues. We produce hormones. Our body is very complicated. But if you eat the right food, you won't eat too much of it, because your hormones will work properly and you won't end up overweight or diabetic or with heart disease. Thank you for your time. Thank you for following. Thank you for liking this video. Thank you for subscribing. Please share this video so that more people understand the truth about the calories in, calories out meme. That's what it is.